So, hi guys. Welcome to the presentation of the last beer club this year.
Doof, doof.
The Mikkeller Beer Club December edition. A small disclaimer for all of you guys. We haven't prepared a lot of dark stuff, just so you know. I know you want it, but...
Maybe in January?
It's not going to be in December. It's going to be in January. So we hope this can kind of stand out as kind of a what you call it, some opposition to your regular disgusting December brews.
All right. Yeah.
Just some introduction. Some of you might know this place. This is the general's room at Warpix. It's our own private dining room that can be booked. It's located in the middle of Warpix, which we have something from today for you guys. If you feel like having a bit more privacy, you can pull the curtains and have the David Lynch kind of vibe in here. You can decide the music. You can pour your own beers. There's
tap system. Yeah.
There's basically everything you need for a really good evening. Order some food, which leads me to a service announcement today. Warpix just started up delivering food in Copenhagen on Vault. So if you're craving this barbecue inferno daily, you can actually get it delivered right to your doorstep. So
left outside your locked door.
Exactly. Yeah. And I think you should start out with the first beer, which is actually not a new beer, but it's a new
like
version
one?
Of an already existing beer. It's made with this year's harvest of Riesling grapes.
From Meyer and our own lanes at his fields in Mosel. So
this is a funny beer because it kind of changes character from year to year. So just like a wine, it's very dependent on this year's harvest. And that's also why you guys deserve it more than once. Oops. And it's just an incredible beer. I kind of feel like this is a beer that has been kind of taken for granted, but it's an amazing beer, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Skål.
Skål.
So, up next, we have a beer that have been a long time in the making. Not in the brewing kettle, but its history dates back quite a while. It's a beer club exclusive. Some of you guys have tried something from Hop Hooligans before, straight out of Bucharest, Romania. I met these guys 4 years ago, maybe, when we opened up the Bucharest place. I went with Mikkel. It's a fun trip, very, very hard trip as well. I did my first 10K after maybe 45 minutes of sleep and a clogged toilet at the news hotel, but that's another story. I met these guys, Hop Hooligans. They made this one for the Mikkeller Beer Club, and that's the guy, officer. That's the bastard that ravaged a perfectly fine kettle sour with so much tasty stuff. I just hope he rots in pastry jail forever. It's made with Columbus hops, with lactose, blackcurrant, cocoa nibs, and tonka beans. Wow, look at that color. I can smell this one from here as well. So
it's very like very much like a dessert.
So before you guys say, way too much sour.
No more
stuff,
sours. It's very mild and round.
It's not very sour.
Actually, no.
This could be like a white stout or something. It actually has more character of a of a stout. Yeah. Just a little bit of sourness.
Fruity sourness, yeah. Okay, so...
Oh, Christmas spirit.
A real Christmas beer. XL from the Dolle Brewers in Essen. And this is a 40-year anniversary beer.
Mm. Oh, would I.
Now Frank can't drink.
Oh, now it's infected.
Maybe you can... I can take another one.
Oh, you have another one?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Always come
what
prepared.
A catastrophe.
And
yeah, it's a dry hopped pale ale, and I think it's quite strong. Comes out at 6.5 ABV, so yeah, that's a bit.
It tastes like Belgium already now. Imagine coming home, nice. You know, you're in the 80s.
Yeah.
You've just heard about the Dolle Brewery. You're coming home from the working in maybe a
coal mine. One of the last coal mines in Charleroi, maybe. Yeah.
I'm not thinking mine. I'm more thinking like a plant where you maybe you make parts for cars, but in Charleroi.
Yeah.
And you just heard that the factory is going to be shut down.
Which they all were. Yeah.
You're depressed and
broke.
You don't know what to do, broke as well. And then you come home and you find this in your fridge. Nice. Then you're all good.
That would be perfect.
Next up, we have something else.
Special.
We have something brewed in the heart of Zealand, at least western part of Zealand. Not too far from Denmark's most beautiful city, Kalundborg. and also not very far from the Danish bridge of Storebæltsbroen.
That's true.
If you don't know what I'm talking about, I'm obviously talking about the birthplace of Kuskebitter, which was a Danish bitter that was brewed for the people driving around with Bovee products. They make ketchup, HB sauce, etc. Yeah. I'm talking about Svinninge. It's brewed in Svinninge. It's called The Guide. It might not be just as good as Kuskebitter. Only two bottles left in the world of Kuskebitter. I have one of them. But it's still supposedly pretty damn good. It's at 7% ABV. It's a New England style.
Which I could imagine also is a bit less than Kuskebitter.
They don't have the equipment to measure how strong Kuskebitter is.
It's very good.
It's good. It's compared to Kuskebitter, it's way more easy drinking, I think.
Yeah. I don't feel like throwing up. Next up, we have Resting Brewface. Imperial New England IPA.
Worth mentioning this is also, it's a rebrew of a San Diego beer, but
yeah,
made
in De Proof.
No.
In Svinninge also?
It's made in the Pearl of Zealand, Pride of Denmark. Svinninge.
Kalundborg.
Torhild City.
Close to Kalundborg.
Academia capital of Denmark, yeah.
It's just what a New England style double IPA is supposed to be. It's
very straightforward.
It's a heavy hitter. It's a go to sleep beer. It's at holy shit! It's a 9% ABV. It's indeed a go to sleep beer. One more double IPA, 8.1%. This is All Things Diet from Third Moon Brewing Company. You probably haven't had anything from these guys before, as they are not exporting outside of Canada. Funny story, I'll make it brief. We were approached by a lovely woman who said that she accidentally broke her husband's Mikkeller glass, and he had a very impressive Mikkeller collection. So we sent her a new glass, and then she sent back a picture of his collection. And his collection was among the sickest Mikkeller collections we've ever seen. He had everything. And then we found out that he actually also was a co-owner of a brewery in Canada that apparently made some super good beers. So we reached out, we bought a batch, and we got it for the beer club. It's hazy, that's for sure. Tastes amazing.
I think it's very
easy drinking.
So, you'll receive one of these, either Frank 2, formerly known as Frank the Tank. Very nice double IPA here from Warpix, named after this young gent over here. Or this fruit sour IPA next door, made in collaboration with Oben from Colling, yeah. And it's made with guava and passion fruit, and I think we should probably start with this one.
All of you guys probably know Den Røde Baron, or the Red Baron in Colling. It's close to that place.
That was why this guy from World War One, he took the name from this place.
Exactly. If you like collaborative fruited sour IPAs, then hope for this one. If you like
collaborative double IPAs.
If you like me, hope for this one.
It's very nice, yeah. Really some jungle flavors.
Frank too. Hazy stuff.
Yeah.
Good stuff. Often I'm thinking, how is it to get a beer named after me? And now I have two beers named after me.
Yeah. It's true.
That's just how it is. Skål. This one is good as well.
So, London's Calling.
Oi,
I should say. From the new brew pub, we got Mo Sislak, which is this guy from Simpsons, I think.
I don't know.
I think so.
And we have Juice Factor. And once again, you're going to receive one of these two.
Yeah.
So, a hazy pale ale, 5.2. Or India pale ale, at 6%. I'll try this one, you try that one.
Yeah, then we'll compare.
Yeah. Mmm. Smells really nice.
I say mine is very good.
Same. Look forward.
He is also very good.
Yeah, this is good stuff.
It's definitely something to look forward to.
Yeah, either way.
Yeah, it's good.
So while Elias is eating his new takeaway stuff, I'm presenting the last beer of this month's beer club. It's a big one, it's a huge one. It's from a brewery that's going to be included in the Mikkeller beer celebration virtual tasting, hosted on the 12th of December. Still a few tickets left, where we have, among others, Fauheim. We also have Three Sons, Three Flights, Mikkeller San Diego, Hill Farmstead, and a lot of other good stuff. Oben, the one collaboration we had from Colling as well.
Just now.
This one. Be prepared to be amazed. It's a Rubuff of Rose. Blend 1? No. Blend 2? No.
Blend 3? 3, yeah.
Oh yes. It's been barrel aged for between 24 and 36 months. So 3 years in the making, and that's only the barrel aging. Let's get some pouring action as well. You can see it pours. It's a deep red color. This is a good one. Mm-hmm. It's very, very raspberry, fresh raspberries in the...
Definitely. But I wouldn't expect anything less.
A lot of sourness. And with that said, I think you guys should just stay put.
And then
until next month.
Until next year.
Until next year.
Yeah.
So maybe
Merry Christmas.
Hope for some dark stuff.
Yes.
Yeah. I know we have some... We have an... I'm going to spoil the beans. We have a crazy, crazy, crazy mofo stout in the kettles with Seven Islands from Corpus, Greece, the old capital of Europe.
Yeah. The old polis.
Exactly.
Yeah.
In the making. So there is some dark stuff coming up. just relax.
Yeah. Happy New Year. Merry Christmas.
Both.
Yeah.